So hello everyone and welcome back once again to another session of topic wise MCQs of general science. In today's session we are going to discuss MCQs from the very important chapter jiska naam hai oscillation and waves. And guys, so many students are asking about the exam dates of ASRB. So remember guys, please do not wait for the exam date. See, this is an opportunity for you. ठीक है, जो आपको टाइम मिला है उस टाइम में ये मत सोचो कि एग्जाम कब होगा, बस अपनी प्रिपरेशन करो एंड यू कैन टेक इट एज एन एडवांटेज बिकॉज सो मेनी पीपल आर नॉट स्टडिंग राइट नाउ, दे आर जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर द एग्जाम डेट्स. सो इन दिस मीन टाइम योर ओपोनेंट्स आर नॉट स्टडिंग, सो यू कैन टेक इट एज एन एडवांटेज एंड यू कैन स्टडी मोर देन देम. सो इसलिए आई वुड रिकमेंड, देखो एग्जाम डेट कब आएगी कब नहीं आएगी किसी को कुछ नहीं पता, मुझे भी नहीं पता, आपको भी नहीं पता. ठीक है, वो एएसआरबी को ही पता है, जब वो एग्जाम कराना चाहेंगे वो डेट दे देंगे. आपका काम इतना है कि बस आपको अपनी प्रिपरेशन जारी रखनी है. एंड सेम विथ ईएसआईसीडीडी, वी डोंट नो कि एग्जाम कब होगा, जब भी होगा हो जाएगा. यू हैव द नोटिफिकेशन, यू हैव द ऑफिशियल नोटिफिकेशन, मतलब एग्जाम तो होगा. सो इन द मीन टाइम कीप ऑन प्रिपेयरिंग. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, डू सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन. यू कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप, हियर यू विल गेट द पीडीएफ ऑफ दिस सेशन अलॉन्ग विद द मार्क्ड आंसर्स. And you can also ask any doubt here. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, which of the following motion is exhibited by a simple pendulum? See, these are not the sessions where I am just telling you the answers. Here I am explaining you each and everything. So agar aap in sessions ko bhi acche se dekh ke jaoge to aapka general science ka kaam ho jayega. Now which of the following motion is exhibited by a simple pendulum? Simple pendulum kaun sa motion exhibit karta hai? Before moving to the answer, let's talk about the types of motion. First, let's talk about the periodic motion. What is this periodic motion, by the way? Periodic motion is the motion, guys, which repeats itself after a regular interval of time. जो कि अपने आप को एक regular interval of time के बाद repeat करता है, that is known as what periodic motion. And the best example is rotation of Earth. Best example is what? Rotation of Earth, or you can say revolution of Earth also. Earth takes 365 one by 4 days to complete one revolution around the sun and it repeats the motion. So this is known as what periodic motion. Similarly, it takes 24 hours around 24 hours to complete one rotation and it again repeats the motion. So that is what periodic motion. Another motion is oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion kya hota hai? It is nothing but to and fro motion. If there is any motion which is to and fro, or you can say back and forth motion, agar koi to and fro motion hai ya fir back and forth motion hai, that is known as what oscillatory motion. Like for example, wo jo jhula hota hai seesaw, that is a to and fro motion. Simple pendulum, simple pendulum kya hota hai? Aisa hota hai, theek hai, ye idhar this is its mean position, it is going to one of its extreme position, then it is coming back, theek hai, then it is going to another extreme position, then again it is coming back. So it is a to and fro motion around this mean position. All right. So this is known as what oscillatory motion. Okay. Then we have another motion, jiska naam hai simple harmonic motion. See, simple harmonic motion is an oscillatory motion only. It is an oscillatory motion only, subject to two conditions. Two conditions hoti hai yahan pe. In fact, three conditions hoti hai. Number one, the amplitude is constant. Constant amplitude. Number two, single frequency. Number two, single frequency. And number three, the motion should be under a restoring force. The motion should be under a restoring force. Let's talk about the example of simple pendulum. See, this is a simple pendulum which is at currently at the mean position. Now we applied a force. It goes to right extreme. Then it comes back. Then it again, then it goes to left extreme and then come back to what? Come back to the mean position. Now, first of all, what is the meaning of amplitude here? Amplitude matlab the maximum distance the object is going towards in one of the extreme. The maximum displacement, not distance. The maximum displacement jo ho raha hai, that is known as what amplitude. So this amplitude should remain constant. And in case of ideal simple pendulum, this amplitude remains constant. What is the meaning of ideal pendulum here? The ideal pendulum is that which is moving without any resistance. Jaise ab normally agar aap air mein pendulum ko ghumaoge to wo ek point pe aake ruk jayega, theek hai, ek certain time ke baad ruk jayega aake, but that is not an ideal pendulum. According to the definition of ideal pendulum, it should be moving without any resistance. ठीक है, बिना किसी resistance के move करना चाहिए. So constant amplitude, then single frequency and then restoring force. Now what is this restoring force, by the way? See, it is moving from mean to this position with the applied force. हमने force apply करी, but why is it coming back? ये वापस क्यों आ रहा है? Because it is moving under a restoring force, जो कि उसको mean position की तरफ लेके आ रहा है. ठीक है, so restoring force also, remember, always acts towards the mean position. ठीक है, and it is because of the restoring force that this to and fro motion is happening in this simple pendulum. The restoring force is due to the restoring force, it is moving towards the mean position again, and then with the same applied force जो कि लगी हुई है, because there is no resistance. और हमने Newton's law में पढ़ा था कि अगर कोई external force नहीं है तो object अपनी जो state of motion है उसको change नहीं कर सकता, तो ये motion में ही रहेगा unless it is acted upon by some external force. ठीक है, so basically simple harmonic motion is an oscillatory motion of constant amplitude of single frequency moving under the influence of a restoring force. So here the correct answer, guys, will be what? Simple harmonic motion, option D. Simple pendulum is an example of simple harmonic motion because all the three conditions are satisfied in case of simple pendulum. ठीक है, yes, practically it is not possible, but here we are talking theoretically. Option D is the correct answer. Question number 2. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to an object executing SHM passing through the mean position? Okay, so let's say this is a pendulum. Let's take the example of pendulum. It is currently at mean position, and when I have applied a force, जब मैंने मान लो कि इसके ऊपर कोई force apply करी, so it is going there, यहाँ पे जाएगा ये, then it will come back, and then it will go back here. ठीक है, and then again to the mean position. ठीक, अब यहाँ पे जरा ध्यान से समझो, अब ये move कर रहा है, ऐसा imagine करो, it is moving. तो जब ये मूव कर रहा है तो ऑफकोर्स वेन इट इज गोइंग टूवर्ड्स दिस एक्सट्रीम राइट एक्सट्रीम विच मीन्स इट इज गेनिंग सम पोटेंशियल एनर्जी क्योंकि ये इस हाइट पे जा रहा है तो इसके अंदर कुछ ना कुछ पोटेंशियल एनर्जी आ रही है एंड ऑफकोर्स जब ये इस तरफ जा रहा है तो इट्स वेलोसिटी इज डिक्रीजिंग और नॉट इट्स वेलोसिटी इज डिक्रीजिंग जब ये ऊपर की तरफ जाएगा ऐसे तो उसकी वेलोसिटी क्या होती रहेगी कम होती रहेगी एंड एट दिस पोजिशन एट एक्सट्रीम पोजिशन की मैं बात करूं तो वी कितना हो जाएगा जीरो यहाँ पे ये रुकेगा तभी तो वापस आएगा V0 and if V0 then definitely kinetic energy is what? Zero. Kinetic energy क्या हो जाएगी? Zero हो जाएगी. ठीक है, और potential energy क्या होगी? Maximum. Potential energy क्या होगी guys? Maximum. Now when it start moving again towards the mean position, what will happen? Its potential energy will go on decreasing, will decrease, and its kinetic energy will increase. Why? Because its velocity is increasing. And at this mean position, velocity will be maximum. Kinetic energy will also be maximum. Kinetic energy maximum होगा, potential energy कितना होगा? Zero हो जाएगा. Clear है? तो velocity maximum, kinetic energy maximum, potential energy zero. And here, at the mean position, acceleration will be zero. And here, the acceleration will be maximum. ठीक है? So these are the cases of an object moving under a moving as a simple moving under the simple harmonic motion and mean or extreme ke upar inke do alag alag wo hai cases hai. So here you have to identify the incorrect statement with respect to the mean position. No force acts on the particle, absolutely correct. Acceleration of the particle is zero, you can see here. Velocity is minimum, no, velocity is maximum at the mean position. So which means the correct answer will be, guys, what? Option C, velocity is not minimum, velocity minimum option में है, but that is the incorrect answer and we have to identify the incorrect statement only. So option C. What is the effect on the time period of a simple pendulum if it is taken to a height above the surface of the earth? Now to answer this question, we have to know about what is the time period of simple pendulum. The formula for time period of simple pendulum is this: T is equals to 2 pi square root of L by G. Now what is the meaning of time period, by the way? The time taken to complete one cycle. Now what is this one cycle? Here it is at mean position, it is going to one of the extreme, then it is coming back to mean, another extreme, and then back to mean. So this completes one cycle. ठीक है, दिस इज नोन एज टाइम पीरियड. द टाइम टेकन टू कंप्लीट वन साइकिल इज नोन एज व्हाट? टाइम पीरियड. एंड व्हाट इज फ्रीक्वेंसी? नंबर ऑफ साइकिल्स पर सेकंड. उल्टा होता है, टाइम पीरियड एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी आर रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ ईच अदर. डू रिमेंबर दिस. फ्रीक्वेंसी इज मेजर्ड इन हर्ट्ज. फ्रीक्वेंसी इज मेजर्ड इन हर्ट्ज. बट हियर द क्वेश्चन इज रिगार्डिंग टाइम पीरियड. सो व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला? टी इज इक्वल टू 2 पाई स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ एल बाय जी. सी, 2 पाई इज अ कांस्टेंट, इट इज अ नंबर. एल इज द लेंथ ऑफ द पेंडुलम. And according to the theoretical definition of pendulum, L should always be remain constant. Matlab, the length of the pendulum, the string through which the bob is attached, should be inextensible. Wo jo string hai, wo inextensible honi chahiye. Agar wo extensible string hogi, then that is not an ideal pendulum. So length is again constant. So time period is completely dependent on the value of acceleration due to gravity or not, because other two terms are constant. Now come back to the question. If it is taken to a height above the surface of the earth, now what will happen to g, to the value of g, if I go to a certain height? So it decreases. हमने पढ़ा था g क्या होता है, decrease हो जाता है. ठीक है, I'm going to a certain height, g decreases. Now if g decreases, time period क्या हो जाएगा? बढ़ जाएगा. Time period क्या होगा? बढ़ जाएगा. Time period बढ़ने का मतलब क्या है? That this pendulum or this simple pendulum, yes, this simple pendulum slows down. जो इसका time period, जो इसका स्पीड होगा वो क्या हो जाएगा? कम हो जाएगा, बिकॉज टाइम पीरियड क्या हो रहा है? बढ़ रहा है. सो हियर द क्वेश्चन इज रिगार्डिंग टाइम पीरियड. सो टाइम पीरियड इंक्रीजेस, ऑप्शन ए विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. सो आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. सो याद करने की बजाय अगर आप कंसेप्चुअली चीजों को समझोगे, सो देन यू वुड बी एबल टू इजिली, यू वुड बी एबल टू आंसर द क्वेश्चन वेरी इजिली. ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 पे आ जाओ. When a body oscillates with its natural frequency or natural frequency with the help of an external periodic force also called forced harmonic motion, and if the frequency provided by the external agent is equal to the natural frequency of the body, the oscillations of the body are called what? See, this is the case when अगर आपके घर के पास से कोई एरोप्लेन गुजरता है and your जो glasses आपके घर के खिड़की के वो टूट गए अगर, so that is due to this phenomenon and this is known as what? Resonant oscillation. अब यहाँ पे हो क्या रहा है? दैट द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ द ग्लासेस ऑफ योर विंडो आर वाइब्रेटिंग विद देयर ओन नेचुरल फ्रीक्वेंसी. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड इज दैट द एरोप्लेन केम एंड इट आल्सो प्रोवाइडेड द साउंड वेव्स ट्रैवलिंग थ्रू द मूवमेंट ऑफ दैट एरोप्लेन दैट प्रोवाइडेड द सेम नेचुरल फ्रीक्वेंसी विद विच द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ ग्लास वर ऑलरेडी मूविंग. इससे क्या होता है कि उनका जो फ्रीक्वेंसी है वो बहुत ज्यादा तेज हो जाता है एंड बहुत तेज होने की वजह से दे टेंड टू मूव आउट ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट एंड दैट्स व्हाई the glass breaks. ठीक है, and this type of oscillation guys is known as what? Resonant oscillation, option C. Which of the following is incorrect with respect to the electromagnetic waves? See, electromagnetic waves are those which have both electric waves and magnetic waves, जिसमें electric field और magnetic field दोनों होता है. ठीक है, electric field और magnetic field दोनों होता है and both are perpendicular to each other. And electromagnetic waves moves perpendicularly to the direction of electric waves and magnetic waves. Matlab is tarike se. Let's say here it is electric field, here it is yahan pe maan lete hain magnetic field hai, and the direction of propagation is this. Theek hai? So all the three, direction of propagation, electric field and magnetic field, all the three are mutually perpendicular to each other in case of electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic waves are transverse waves. There are two types of waves, we all know, transverse and longitudinal, although aur bhi hote. Electromagnetic wave moves with the speed of light. All the electromagnetic waves move with the speed of light, and of course, since they have electric field and magnetic field, they must have some kind of energy and they must have some kind of momentum. Why? Because electric field or magnetic field mein energy or momentum to dono ho gaye. Theek hai? And the nature of these are, they are neutral. ठीक है, नेचर इनका कैसा होता है? न्यूट्रल होता है. सो हियर यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. दे आर न्यूट्रल, यस. दे प्रोपेगेट एज लॉन्गिट्यूडनल वेव, नो. दे प्रोपेगेट एज ट्रांसवर्स वेव, ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन. बट बाकी भी पढ़ लेते हैं. दे प्रोपेगेट विद द वेलोसिटी ऑफ लाइट, करेक्ट, एंड दे कंटेन एनर्जी एंड मोमेंटम, करेक्ट. सो ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर गाइस टू दिस क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 पे आ जाओ. द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इज मैक्सिमम इन सॉलिड्स and minimum in gases. Very easy question, very very easy question. The speed of sound is maximum in solids and it is minimum in gases. Why is it so? Why it is maximum in solids? Because sound needs material medium to travel. Sound uses the particles of medium to travel. For its propagation, sound uses the particles of the medium. And of course, in the case of solids, the particles are compact as compared to the gases. Gases mein particles dur dur hote hain, solids mein paas paas hote hain. And that is why the sound wave can travel faster in case of solid.
So if I talk among solid, liquids and gases, solids has the maximum speed, sound has the maximum speed in solid, then in liquid, and then finally in gases. So the correct answer will be solid, comma gases. Option C will be the correct answer.
Question number 7 pe chalte hain. What is the minimum distance from a sound reflecting surface to hear an echo? Echo sunne ke liye between the source and the observer. Between the source and the observer, kitna distance hona chahiye? Between the source and the reflector, you can say. Let's say this is a person standing in front of a mountain. ठीक है? Echo आपने सुना ही होगा. तो mountain और इसके बीच में ये reflector है. तो इनके बीच में जो minimum distance है ये कितना होना चाहिए? This minimum distance guys should be 17 meter. Only then echo can be possible. Otherwise not. इसके अलावा अगर आपको जो खाली कमरे में जो आवाज repeat होती है, that is not echo. Because in case of echo, you can hear the whole word. Like for example, if I अगर मैं चिल्लाता हूँ मनीष, तो मुझे पूरा मनीष सुनाई देगा. बट इन केस ऑफ छोटा रूम, अगर कोई छोटा रूम है तो मुझे आखिरी के कुछ जैसे अगर मैं बोलता हूँ साइंस, तो आखिरी का जो स वाला साउंड है वो सुनाई देता है. तो उस फिनोमिनन को हम क्या बोलते हैं? रिवर्बरेशन. दैट इज नॉट एको, दैट इज वॉट रिवर्बरेशन. एंड टू रिमूव द रिवर्बरेशन, टू गेट अवे विद रिवर्बरेशन इन द ऑडिटोरियम्स, इन द सिनेमा हॉल्स, इन द म्यूजिक स्टूडियोज, फाइबर्स आर यूज्ड, कार्पेट्स आर यूज्ड, कर्टेन्स आर यूज्ड. दैट्स व्हाई जो सिनेमा हॉल्स होते हैं वहां पे कार्पेट लगे होते हैं, हमारे स्वागत के लिए नहीं होते हैं, वो रिवर्बरेशन को कम करने के लिए होते हैं. सो ऑप्शन डी 17 मीटर इज द करेक्ट आंसर. द अपेरेंट चेंज इन द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ सोर्स ड्यू टू रिलेटिव मोशन बिटवीन सोर्स एंड ऑब्जर्वर इज कॉल्ड व्हाट? सी दिस इज वेरी बेसिक फिनोमेनन, यू मस्ट हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड दिस. लेट्स से यू आर स्टैंडिंग हियर ऑन द रेलवे प्लेटफॉर्म एंड अ ट्रेन इज अप्रोचिंग यू, एंड यहाँ पे इसका जो साइरन है वो बज रहा है. तो जब ये आप अभी ये दूर है तो आपको इसका जो साउंड है कम सुनाई दे रहा होगा. जैसे जैसे पास आएगा द साउंड, द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ साउंड विल गो ऑन इंक्रीज, एंड देन जब ये दूर जाएगा देन इट विल अगेन डिक्रीज. ठीक है? विच मीन्स द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ साउंड जो है वो रिलेटिव मोशन की वजह से क्या हो रही है? चेंज हो रही है. नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ रिलेटिव मोशन? वन ऑब्जेक्ट एट रेस्ट, अनदर इज मूविंग. टू ऑब्जेक्ट्स मूविंग विद द डिफरेंट वेलोसिटीज. ठीक है? And if they are moving with the same velocity, that is not relative motion. If they are both are rest, that is also not relative motion. Relative motion, in dono se cheezon se samjho. So this effect, guys, is known as what? Doppler's effect. And the same effect is observed in the case of light waves also. Option E is the correct answer. Question number 9 pe chalte hain. Which of the following relations depict the correct relation shape between velocity of wave, its frequency and wavelength? See, wave kya hota hai? Wave is a form of disturbance through which the wave is a disturbance through which the disturbance moves. ठीक है? Wave basically is a form of disturbance. ठीक है? जिसकी वजह से वो disturbance आगे move होती है. Now the velocity of wave is determined by velocity is equal to wavelength upon time, because velocity we all know is displacement upon time, and in case of waves the displacement is measured by wavelength. Wavelength upon time. Now we all know, we can write it like this: wavelength into 1 by time. Okay, and 1 by time is what? Frequency. So wavelength is equals to lambda into nu. Matlab lambda into frequency. Sorry, velocity is equals to wavelength into frequency. So option A will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 10, which is the last question for this session. What happens to the speed of sound if pressure of the medium in which sound traveling is increased? See, very easy question. There is no effect of pressure on the speed of sound. Whether the pressure is increased or it is decreased, there is no effect. Okay? But do remember, if we increase the temperature, if we increase the temperature of medium, then the speed of sound will increase. जो साउंड की स्पीड होगी वो क्या होगी? इंक्रीज हो जाएगी. इफ वी इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर और वाइस वर्सा, अगर कम कर देंगे तो कम भी हो जाएगी. So here the question is regarding pressure. Option C, no change will be the correct answer.
And that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you want to buy the courses, you can visit to anujindal.in. There is a Halloween discount which is going on all the courses. And I'll see you next week with 10 most important questions from another chapter. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.